I have life with a special definition of life, with a life goal to serve the humanity. I have strived with dedication and have left behind my suffering. Separation of Afghan people at the peak by the communist regime and invasion of Russia, hundreds of human lost their life daily to gunfire or heavy artillery. Hundreds more were imprisoned or were compelled to leave the country. I was also one of the victims. I was imprisoned twice, once by the communist regime and then by the Mujahideen group, because I was defending human rights and for being a humanitarian worker. My struggle also unnerved the Taliban, who made my life difficult in the country. However, I've left the country before getting harmed. I live as a refugee for 18 years in Peshawar, Pakistan. Serving thousands of Afghan refugees in Pakistan becomes my life goal. Afghan refugee who had fled the country due to oppression of the politician and completion of superpower had no shelter, no jobs, and no educational opportunities. I have put a lot of efforts in this cause and did my level best. After a short period of service as a school teacher, I established an English language institution in 1990, Kabul English Language Center, that is functioning up to date, 2015. It enabled thousands of Afghan youth to learn the English language. To many Afghan youth, it became the first step of their academic journey and helped hundreds of Afghan youth to embark on their graduate and postgraduate studies. This achievement is extremely fulfilling and gratifying. I thank all my colleagues who supported this cause. Following the Kabul English Language Center, I pioneered the publication of a monthly magazine for children, The Rainbow, in Dari called Rangin Kamon. Was printed for 12 consecutive years in 143 versions. It was one of the few magazines for Afghan children, the readers of which are in their youth and still remind me of their great memories of reading it. My third noteworthy initiative was the establishment of a primary school for Afghan refugees in Pakistan. Sadia Primary School has facilitated the education for thousands of Afghan refugees since 1992. The series of such initiatives continued. I took the initiative of establishing two libraries, a computer instructing course, a tailoring vocational course for war widow, a teacher training initiative, an English newspaper, The Treasure, and many more that help with education and improving the life of Afghan refugees. I took all these initiatives voluntarily with moral and technical support of my friends and colleagues. I take this opportunity to thank all my friends who have supported me in this endeavor. Especially I thank my wife who stood by my side in all the hardship of our life with resilience and patience. Although I was already engaged in serving the Afghan people, I also became curious about achieving peace in the country. Since most of the political program for peace had failed already, I tried to explore a non-political solution to durable peace in Afghanistan. Over time and effort, I learned that the only way to achieve peace is through community-based peace building. For Afghan refugees, endure prolonged psychological suffering. I determined that to achieve community-based peace, the attitude of people should change and expand, and they should be given the opportunity to live in peace and coexistence. Afghanistan is one of the few countries that have lost everything to war. even people's moral attitude and behavior have suffered. Today, Afghanistan suffers from ethnic, political, and religious prejudice, power struggle, violence against women, and discrimination of all kinds. We have witnessed some reconstruction effort during the last decade, but I am worried about the destruction of human attitude, the remedy of which requires deliberate plans, continuous efforts, and longer periods of time. The destruction of morals have dire consequences. The main implication we have seen so far are in form of the Taliban, the emergence of ISIS, suicide schools, and emerging communities full of people prepared for violence. There is no doubt that wrong politics of world power, our neighbors, lobbies of arms manufacturing companies have had their role in conflict of Afghanistan. However, my struggle against them is impractical and unrealistic. What seemed practical was to work on developing people's thinking for building peace. Hence, ISDU was established to practically work for building peace in the country. The vision of ISDU is peaceful Afghanistan free from violence, discrimination, and inequality, where there is social cohesion and harmony between its people, and in which everyone enjoys equal access to essential services and the right to participate in the decision-making process. To achieve this vision, ISDU have implanted numerous projects on community-based peacebuilding since 1997. External and internal evaluation of this project indicate that their results have been effective. Finding of the evaluation report indicate that the project have at least prevented hundreds of murders and injuries of people, and thousands of people have lived in harmony between each other. Some examples of these projects are establishing more than 600 peace councils in different provinces that autonomously function to resolve community conflict, a peace ambassadors initiative that aims to build bridge between two ethnic groups, and have resolved more than 1,100 community-level conflicts, conducting hundreds of capacity-building workshops for religious leaders, journalists, civil servants, NGO representatives, and community leaders on peace-building and conflict resolution. Fortunately, ISDU is one of the recognized peace-building organizations in the country. We have used publication as another means for promoting peace and nurturing peaceful human relations. Our publication in different forms have reached to lakhs of readers and might have positively contributed to their personal development. We have printed 13 topics of pictorial story books for children aged 8 to 12. Our assessment suggested that the 1,000 copies of the books have positively affected children. Children have memorized the story and shared them with each other. All of these books convey the subtle messages for peace and coexistence. Another initiative that I feel proud of is production of 30 to 40 minutes short film for children titled Peace is Life, The Palm Reader Ant, and Devil and Angel. This film encourages children to good behavior and compassion for humanity. All of these films have been broadcasted by the Afghan National Television several times, reaching to thousands of children.
اطفال میبینم از خطای کف دست حال و احوال میبینم
برشتا جانی دیو بیت کارورا کی هست؟ ای دیو جنگ هست؟
خوی امو دیو جنگ هست که پدر مادر ما را از دست ما گرفتن ما را یتیم ساختن
سلام بیبی جان
I have also directed and produced a feature film named Pabrahna the Barefoot. The film depicts the life of an Afghan children who lost his parents in a suicide attack. The child overcomes the hardship and misery of life and achieves greater success through his passion for football. This film is an attempt to shed more light on the wickedness of war and goodness of peace and justice.
Amit, shoot!
On top of this monthly Peace Building magazine, Peace Building Journal, Solidarity magazine, and tens of peace building training manuals have been the publication of Sana'i Development Organization and my personal initiative for promoting peace in Afghanistan. Finally, I'd like to stress on the importance of peace education curriculum. The peace education curriculum of Sana'i Development Organization is a unique product of 5 rounds of revision over a 7-year period. It's a complete school curriculum for class 1 to class 12 and unique for its contents. More important is its unique local adaptation. The curriculum is based on the problem of Afghan context, type of arising conflict in Afghanistan, and experience of local Afghan and staff members of SDO. Our intermediate objective of developing the peace education curriculum is to facilitate the inclusion of peace education in the national school curriculum, and we have been advocating for it. Before I finish, I'd like to thank Cooperation for Peace and Unity, Kapow, Mr. Ehsan Ziaw, the former Minister of Rural Rehabilitation and Development, and Mr. Fahim Hakim, the former Deputy Director of Independent Human Rights Commission, for their comprehensive support in developing the curriculum. We are confident that the peace education curriculum is not only effective in Afghanistan, but it can also prove effective for other countries similar to Afghan context. I am proud to win the International Peace Education Prize of the El Hebri Foundation for 2015. I would like to thank the El Hebri Foundation, the selection committee, and all staff members involved. I assure them that their decision is right.